We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this.
You found him. Amar is one of the founders of the Qataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption.
Time to earn your pay, people. Put on your game faces.
I tell you, I'm not too comfortable working with Pat Qatari and these rebels. Their kind of ideology always ends up with more bodies in the ground. What's your feeling on this op, Nomad?
End of the day, this is a revenge mission. I'll drive.
Hey, let me tell you, Wade, this thing is blinging. Chrome on the handlebars and spokes, white wall tires.
What the fuck, Perico? Where the fuck am I gonna ride a lowrider bicycle around fucking Bolivia, eh? No way. This is the fucking jungle, pendejo. You expect me to roll a goddamn bicycle down El Camino de la Muerte? Pinche broma, cabrón.
Hello? Andres? Sigues ahí? Well, I guess we'll start over. Be our 10th caller, and win this week's Boost the Beater contest!
What do you think's gonna happen to this country if and when Santa Blanca leaves?
What? Bolivians take over again.
This country's all changed. Used to be FARC taking Bolivian cocaine to Mexico. FARC moves out, some other guy moves in. Now Santa Blanca moves out, who comes next? I mean, shit, Santa Blanca has done a hell of a lot to build up the cocaine industry's infrastructure in this country. In this province, you've seen how much they've invested in pyrolusite production alone? All these buildings, this equipment, even the logistical template, it's just gonna be sitting there when the next cartel moves in.
Shut up, dude. You're making me feel all depressed and useless.
Okay, tell me if you've heard this one. A sailor sitting in a bar.
I've heard this one.
I don't give a shit. Anyway, this sailor's sitting in a bar and he leans over to the guy next to him and says, "You want to hear a Marine joke?" And the guy next to him replies, "Before you tell the joke, you ought to know. I'm 6 feet tall, weigh 200 pounds, and I'm a Marine. The guy next to me is 6 foot two, weighs 225, and is also a Marine. And the guy next to him, he's 6'5", weighs 250, and is a Marine too." Now he says, "Do you still want to tell that joke?" The sailor thinks about it for a minute, and shakes his head.
"Frag out, come on, stop, bitches!"
"Nah," he says.
"Grenade, move!"
"Fuck. How about you not let me get shot next time?"
"Grenade, watch out!"
Frag out. Come in mierda, culeros.
Frag out. Hola, bitches.
Frag out. Get some.
Damn, that's gonna hurt in the morning.
Thanks. Here we go. Frag out.
took you so long?
Frag out, come on, stop, grenade. Bitches!
Frag out. Come in here to Culeros.
Move!
Frag out.
Frag out. Eat it, fuckers.
Grenade!
See you in hell.
Grenade,
move! Frag out, hold up, bitches.
Grenade, watch out!
Brief recording of what Jorge and Inca Camina has to say on the topic.
Oh, mercy!
I will hear your confession. Perhaps then, Santa Muerte will forgive you.
I don't know any.
Grenade, move!
frag out.
Grenade, move!
Frag out! I'm gonna stop, bitches!
Grenade, get to cover!
Grenade, move!
Frag out, see you in hell!
Grenade,
get to cover! Guns down, fellas. We don't want to scare them all off. Hostiles in the area. Everybody hold up, we got hostiles in the area. He's gone.
That's it, we're clear.
Damn, I love this drop.
No, fine, you relax, I'll drive.
We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up the supplies later.
Frag out.
Perico here giving you advice from the man who has heard it all and seen a little bit. Things have been a little crazy around here the last couple days. Santa Blanca even made the news in the States. And though that sounds cool for a criminal enterprise, it's not such a great thing. This could have been avoided if we had been looking out for each other. You may not have met him, but you all know Ricky Sandoval, the man at the King.
So these two Marines board a flight to Houston. Marines and planes. This ought to be good. No sooner had they settled down into their seats than an Army corporal comes down the aisle and took the seat next to them. So the corporal settles in, pulls off his boots, and gets comfortable. Now the two Marines take one look at this guy and decide they're gonna have a little fun. After the plane's in the air, the Marine in the window seat turns to the corporal. Hey buddy, he says, you mind grabbing a drink for me? No problem, the Army guy says, and hops up to get a drink from the flight attendant. While he's gone, the Marine takes one of the corporal's boots and spits it.
That's just nasty.
The corporal comes back with the Marine's drink. He's just getting comfortable again when the second Marine grins and says, hey man, that drink sure looks good. You mind getting one for me too? And you know what? The corporal just grins. You bet, he says.
The drone is
and
up.
Hops right on up. As soon as he's gone, the Marine
Tango
grabs the other boot
close
and hocks
to
a big old loogie right inside. The Marines sit back and enjoy their drinks. A couple hours later, the bird
tango.
Touches
Marking
down.
A tango.
The corporal
he's close
pulls
to that
on
local.
His boots. And right away, he knows what's happened. He turns to the jarheads, who are both giving him these shit-eating grins. How long must this go on? This hatred, this animosity, this spitting in boots and pissing in drinks.
Hold up, they're gonna see you.
That's one tango down. Clear over here.
And the target. Let's move.
Deploying drone.
Deploying the tango.
There's a third one.
Got another. That's five.
He's history.
That guy's history.
We're good. We're good.
Here's the deal, asshole. You answer my questions or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit.
That's what
Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck out, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing? He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
We need to get this done in a hurry. Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, maybe not. Amaru's a major player in the rebel movement. The cartel will keep him alive as long as they can to find out what
Frag
he knows.
Out!
We can't afford to take any chances. It's too much... Thanks.
Grenade!
Eyes up. Let's get back to work. We can't afford to take any chances. Too much riding on this. Let's move. Let's get moving. The cartel isn't gonna wait around for us to track down and rescue Amaru.
There's a third one. Damn, that sure got his attention. That was fucking close. I think that's all of them.
God damn.
driving.
El Sueño. The sicarios have found the escaped prisoner in the village of Culta.
What a wonderful name for a town. They were protecting him.
Sí. The village is known to Unidad as a haven for rebels.
Why do these rebels even bother? Kill them all. The whole village. Visit divine wrath upon Culta. And wipe it off the face of the earth.
Claro. Al rato.
Pendejos, stop what you're doing and give a listen to some words of wisdom from El Sueño.
A boy once asked me, what makes a good sicario? The question gave me pause. We do not recruit sicarios through job listings in the newspaper. We recruit the people we know. Amigos from La Calle, duros we might meet in prison. And we may see something in these hombres that we like, something that has potential. But the boy who asked the question, what makes a good sicario, was asking because he wanted to know who he should be, who he should become. There are many qualities that a good sicario must try to have. Cojones, strength, good aim with a rifle, cunning. Very few men in this world have all these gifts, but in truth, a man needs none of them to be a good sicario. The only thing a man needs is loyalty. Santa Blanca, the Santa Muerte, and to me. When a man gives his loyalty to our cause, it gives him the other characteristics he needs. Loyalty will give him the cunning to make his money. It will give him the strength to move mountains, and it will give him the aim to kill his enemies. And if a man gives me his loyalty, I give mine back. He will share in the fruits of our cause, and he will have his place in our paradise. But if a man does not, he will suffer the same fate as our betrayer, Ricky Sandoval. He will die in agony, screaming till his lungs give out, and then he will be discarded, tossed away into the dirt, like the garbage he is.
That truck is running off. Christ almighty!
Deploying drone.
Drone going up. Got one.
Good shooting. No, that was messy. Clean up and move on.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, we're getting you out of here.
That truck's hightailing it out of here.
These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
This thing's got plenty of gas.
I'm taking the bike.
Second target. Count is now 5.
Drone is airborne.
Mine's in a small group of tangos. I'm looking at a small group of tangos.
Yo, I just saw this shit on TV. It's the battle called the American Drug Czar. Which, by the way, in Chicago is gonna be a city.
para no meterme en un problema. Quieto. Nomás te amo. No, ya cállate. Pinche vieja, lo estoy haciendo por ti.
That's it, we're clear. Check it out, weapons case.
Alguien ayúdeme a salir de aquí.
This'll go nice with my boots.
I've written these things enough. I'm sure I can figure this out.
Escucha, cabrones. Sé que están ahí. Así que escuchen bien. La rebelión no perdona.
Oye, hermano, te pasó mucho tiempo. Ayúdenos, por favor.
Didn't you hear the Pentagon had too many generals, so they decided to get rid of some of them?
It's about damn time.
Well, somebody with the Joint Chiefs came up with the idea of offering $10,000 of severance pay for each inch of the general's body. The generals could be measured any way they chose. An Air Force general goes first. He's a smart guy, so he says he wants to be measured from head to toe. They measure him and come up with 70 inches, so he accepts a severance of $700,000. Next up was an Army general.
Where are you taking me?
Back to your friends.
Entonces Pat Katari has made his deal with the malditos extranjeros, the young fool.
Take it up with him, senor.
PSYOP unit down here, don't you think? Or the MISO, or whatever they're called now.
Shit, there might be one here already for all we know. Bowman plays her cards close to the chest.
You don't think Bowman's got other operators out here?
You think the activity's just a bunch of chairborne rangers? They might not be throwing lead, but somebody else is out here. In a weapons case.
Awesome. I can put this to use.
Are you hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri and Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days. Maybe four. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock. Heads up. Bowman's file on Yuri and Polito is coming through. That's the rundown on La Yuri and El Polito. They're a key part of Santa Blanca's security operation. Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on their chain of command.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency, and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a buchón named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop, for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
The guy in charge of security is El Muro, the Wall. Personal bodyguard and childhood friend to El Sueño.
El Muro's little brother is La Plaga. Nasty piece of shit. Very active on social media. Head Sicario for the cartel.
The hunt starts now. We want Sueño, we gotta work our way up the hierarchy. First targets are Yuri and Polito. We find the intel, we track them down, we take them out.
Nomad, I've got Pacatari on the line. Sounds like he needs our help.
Put him through.
Hola, compadre. I have a problem in Itaqua, and Bowman says you may be able to help. My people need help. There have been many losses to the cartel, and the horrors inflicted by Yuri and Polito have broken their spirit. The fires of revolution have almost gone out.
Spare me the rhetoric, Katari. Just tell me what you need.
There is a cartel supply convoy passing through the province soon. Capturing it would give my people much-needed supplies and restore their morale. Can you do this?
Consider it done.
We're taking orders from Pat Katari now?
Katari needs this convoy. We are gonna give it to him. The more he depends on us to get shit done, the more we can get out of him in return.
I gotta say, I feel bad for Agent Sander. But that guy was crazy. I mean, his balls must have knocked against his knees. They were so big.
6 years undercover? It's damn brutal.
Think of all the evil shit he must have done to become Swingo's right hand. You're not just driving the guy around. Sandoval's dropping bodies, making sure shipments of cocaine end up on the street, doing the bad deed to the people you're supposed to be working to protect. That's what gets me. How'd he live with it for that long?
Shit. He's dead now, so I guess he did. So there's this army ranger I leave out in my neck of the woods and decided he wanted to get himself a pair of alligator boots. But you know, we're talking a ranger here. He wasn't gonna go to no shoe store. No, he gets himself a knife and heads out to the bayou to get him a gator and make some boots for himself. So he gets off the highway and heads back into the country and finds a little old bait shop near the edge of the swamp. He asks the man where he can find himself a gator, and the man gives him directions into the bayou.
This doesn't end with banjo music, does it?
Just let me tell the story, okay? Anyway, the guy at the bait shop says, "Look here, while you're out there, keep an eye out for these two Marines I sent in a couple days ago. They were after gator boots too, and they should have been back by now." Ranger says, he'll keep an eye out for them, and heads into the bayou. He follows the man's directions and heads way out in the swamp. When he gets to where he's going, sure enough, he sees these two Marines standing up to their waist in the water. Over on the shore nearby, there's like 20 dead gators in the mud. Now, as the ranger watches a gator swim up to the Marines, this jarhead jumps on the gator, kills it with his knife, drags it up on the shore, flips it over, and looks at the gator's feet. He said, "Damn it! This one ain't got on no boots either."
Let's roll. Thank you.
got a Sicario with a submachine gun. The cemetery. See?
That's a kill.
Eyes on a second target. Get back before they make it. Enemy down.
Down.
Clear on my side. I'll fly her.
Cartel commendation here. I think Santa Blanca gives out a lot of these.
So how brutal is Yuri and Polito's torture, anyway?
I sure as hell don't want to find out.
But I mean, obviously, it's nothing as softball as waterboarding, right? I mean, we're talking permanent damage and death here.
They're also medically drained, so you have to figure there are some pharmaceuticals at work to keep their victims awake.
See, back in the day, the real torturers didn't need drugs to keep their victims awake.
So they're amateurs.
That's obvious from how few people survived their interrogations. A real torturer, a professional. He or she is in control. He or she understands what's needed. Yuri and Polito are sloppy. They get carried away. They do it for the fun of it, not because it's a job and not for the art. So yes, they're brutal, but not because they try to be. They're brutal because they're incompetent.
You've got a dark side hidden under that smile, don't you?
Spotting another tango. Here's target number 5. I've I got eyes on a sniper.
Tango 10.
The drone is up. Eyes on a small group of tangos.
Target eliminated.
There's a weapons case over here. I've been wanting one of these. We're good. We all in one piece? Thank you.
which has somehow found its way into my body, into my bones and muscles. But you, my hermanos, my sicarios, you still have the madness of youth. Do not underestimate it. Do not take it for granted. Drink it for all that it is worth. Enjoy your strength. Try to exceed, to expand its limits. You still believe that you can achieve anything, and I tell you, for your own benefit, for the benefit of Santa Blanca, you must try. There is much in life to be accomplished. Start now, while the foolishness of youth runs in your veins, and before Santísima Muerte takes you.
There's an Air Force colonel and a Delta operator sitting next to each other on a flight out of King Khalid.
Is this the one where the Delta operator skins the Air Force colonel and wears him like a suit?
What? No, different story.
Oh, man, I love that one.
Anyway, they're both headed back home after a long deployment. The Delta guy's been out in the desert doing, you know, Delta stuff, and he just wants to rack out for a while. But the Air Force colonel, he's on, like, his eighth espresso, and he's feeling chatty. So the colonel says, hey, you want to play a game to pass the time? It's a great game. You'll love it. Here's how it works. I ask you a question. If you can't answer it, you pay me $5. Then you get to ask me a question. If I can't answer it, I pay you $500. The Delta guy sighs and thinks it over. Go ahead, he says. The colonel grins. What's the distance between Earth and Neptune, he says. The Delta operator thinks of it. Finally, he frowns, reaches into his pocket, and hands over $5. The Air Force guy, he...
The hell happened here?
GPS says the place is named Yopil.
I don't see any signs of fighting. It's just a ghost town.
I suppose either the cartel or the dogs chased everybody off.
Encuentre todo y encuéntrelo al mejor precio solo en Mercad, la cadena de supermercados líder en Bolivia. Si no lo encuentra en Mercad, no lo encuentra en Bolivia.
You have paid your dues, suffered the same hardships, accomplished the same successes as your male co-workers. But because you are a woman, you'll always be seen as la trapadora who fucked her way up the ranks of the cartel. This is Lidia Flores. And orgullosas...
I got a narco over here.
Tell me where.
Right by that stack of tires.
Drone is airborne.
Target down.
Think I can wear this with my Class A uniform? Buckle up, people.
Heads up, hostiles in here.
Looking at a small group of tangos.
Man, if you shot straight, I wouldn't get fucked up.
Eyes on a small group of tangos. We're clear. ¿Qué haces? Got any chiz made by the cartel or the Sicarios?
Gracias. Guess who has the details on the supply helicopter just aching to be stolen?
So an Army Ranger, a Recon Marine, a SEAL, and a Delta operator are sitting around a campfire.
Here we go.
The Ranger, being a Ranger, starts bragging about how tough he is. You think you guys are tough, he says? I parachuted behind enemy lines, done a 50-mile night march, and killed a dozen terrorists with my bare hands. The Recon Marine is like, man, that ain't shit.
I've landed on a beach in the dark, marched 60 miles without stopping, and killed 50 terrorists with my bare hands.
Marines can talk? I call bullshit.
Anyway, the SEAL is like, bitch, please. I've swam 70 miles from a submarine, landed on a beach, marched 80 miles without stopping, and then straggled a whole damn terrorist camp with my bare hands. The SEAL gives him all this big shit-eating grin and turns to the Delta operator. Top that, he says.
Should be
the
okay.
The Delta guy doesn't say a word. He just shakes his head and keeps on stirring the coals of the fire with his dick.
Imagine we'd be still in vaccines and shutting down the relief agency.
For real. This NGO is some diabolical shit. Here we are trying to help these people, but it feels like we're the bad guys.
Don't lose sight of the fact that the only reason the cartel is doing this is because they're using the locals for their own ends.
What's the alternative? We let these people starve? They've got nothing, man. And the government isn't going to step in. You and I both know that.
I hear you, but if we do nothing...
Genius that he is always designing and constructing new equipment for Santa Blanca. I've known him and his family for many years, and I've always known that he has a special gift. See, chiquillo.
Neta? Is it fully submersible? Or is it one of these floaters that he
I'll drive.
Trump, Brown just missed him. He's looking for the source.
Fucking hell!
Target number two, there.
That's it, we're clear.
Enemy down.
Las unidades blindadas están respondiendo con todo para asegurar el área.
Target down.
Out of the car, now. Don't make this harder than it has to be.
Let's go.
This is Nidia Flores. If you're a buchona like I am, your entire life people have called you bossy. Madonna. For me, my mother was the first person to call me
Madonna. You think that guy El Cardenal actually believes his own bullshit about the cartel?
Why not?
Because they torture and kill innocent people almost every damn day. How the hell do you do that with a straight face?
Because they pay him a shitload of money. Hell, I'd say nice things about you if you paid me enough.
There are even some women out there, successful women, who want to ban the actual word bossy. But people who are satisfied being pleasant, who don't act bossy, even if they don't like the word, they don't get what they fucking want. They don't make millions of dollars a month shipping products all over the world. They don't have a hacienda or hundreds of sicarios ready to die for them. So chicas, be mandonas.
be bossy. If you're una cohibida and you're not una cabrona, you won't ever be the fucking boss.
Las mentes cerradas. The small-minded will tell you that Santa Muerte is
looking
a dark
religion,
morbid and dangerous. I say that ordinary morality is for children and simpletons. An attraction to death has long been one of mankind's great taboos, and taboos are made to be broken. Why else do we gorge ourselves on holidays?
Your LT is trying to run.
Get the hell out of there. Son of a... The fucking target's in the vehicle.
He's down.
Gowl is down.
Estamos dentro. A todas las unidades, comiencen el ataque.
Just spotted one with submachine guns. I got a target carrying submachine guns.
Estamos dentro. A todas las unidades, comiencen el ataque.
Buckle up, people.
Después.
the PSYOP has made that many locals go over to the cartels?
I doubt it. Probably makes a lot of them turn a blind eye to Santa Blanca. But I don't think it's recruited many Bolivians who weren't forced into joining.
Still, turning a blind eye ain't the same thing as joining the rebels.
¿Qué haces? Got any chisme by the cartel or the Sicarios? Gracias. Clear. How are you guys holding up? We'll leave a marker so the rebels can pick up these supplies later.
eyes on another target.
Only one piece?
Tango's danger close.
Drone. Looking at a small group of tangos. Eyes on a small group of tangos.
Yeah.
Estamos dentro. A todas las unidades, comiencen el ataque. Tenemos fuerzas hostiles en el área. Preparen el ataque.
Boom, target down. Shooting. Let's clean up and move on. Got rid of a cartel supply chopper here. Should make it easy to intercept and reroute it towards the rebels. Let's get to it. We'll let the rebels know where to find these supplies. They can pay us back later. Cartel would make it nicer metal.
No problem.
Thank you.
The lieutenant's escaping. Enemy down. Alert's over. That'll make things easier. We're clear over here.
Pinche cabrón.
Talk, motherfucker.
Puta madre. Ya está. Entrego las armas.
I don't get paid enough for this shit, cabrón. I'll tell you.
This document mentions an Unidad captain who sends prisoner to Yuri and Polito for interrogations. He's got to know where our lovebirds are, but he's sitting in an Unidad firebase. Drive.
Last time you talked to your family?
Right before we shipped out for Bolivia.
You? I tried to call, but missed him. Probably at my son's football practice. Had to leave a voicemail.
That's rough. You miss him?
Every damn day. That don't matter. I'm still getting divorced.
The covert deployments must be worse. Can't say where you're going, can't say when you're coming back. One day you're there, next day you're gone. I don't know how they do it.
To tell you the truth, I'm just happy I'm getting an honest divorce. Remember Kozak? Motherfucker came home and his wife cleaned out the whole goddamn house except for a single fucking chair. Cleaned out the bank account, too.
I just try to make every moment count when I'm home. Give them everything I got. Hope it's enough.
And now y'all sad sack motherfuckers see why I'm still single. All I'm worried about back home is the lift kit I ain't yet put on my truck.
Drone is airborne. Looking at a small group of tangos.
got a 20 in the garage where Pluto parks his sports car. We snag that, we snag his GPS. Maybe
Tango
something
down.
There tells us where he and his girlfriend are.
Target down. Two Sicarios. The checkpoint, over there.
Muerto.
Rather the cage.
Drag it down.
Relax, Stoker.
Pinche cabrón.
Talk, motherfucker.
I don't get paid enough for this shit, cabrón. I'll tell you.
Yo, I got a weapons case here. Ah, I could use this.
Bowman says the Beauty Queen set up her own charity.
Quite the philanthropist.
Right. Money laundering?
Worse. Kind of student exchange program. She takes Palladian teens and sends them north to the U.S., east to Europe.
I'm guessing they never make it to the Eiffel Tower.
Drug mules.
What happens if they refuse?
Santa Blanca probably holds their families hostage here. Any of the teenagers ever get away?
As far as I could tell, only one. But as soon as he did, Nidia Flores sent his parents and two sisters to El Pozolero.
Pozolero?
The stew maker. He puts people in 200-liter drums with water and sodium hydroxide. After 8 hours, there's nothing left but teeth, nails, and stew. Usually they're already dead before they go in the drum.
This time they weren't.
Fucking monsters.
Heads up, hostile presence.
Déjenos en paz, carajo. ¿Ahora qué? ¿Nos van a matar, pues? ¡Paren! ¿Por qué nos van a hacer que escute otro lado, compa?
The drone is up.
¿Por qué no se van a hacer que les pute a otro lado, compa?
Thunder, thunder, thunder.
Heinz and a small group of tangos. Shit balls. Hostile down. Tango down.
Leave the chopper here and the rebels will pick it up. This is a commendation. Looks like it came from a box of cereal or the Air Force or something. I'll drive.
We got Tango, danger close. Yo, two
got location on an SB antenna. Mark that for deactivation. Who's up for plugging a rebel radio?
Hold on.
Enemy down.
Estamos por todas partes, nada. Los culeros ya se fueron.